Liza Mundy, she's the author of The Richer Sex, How the New Majority of Female Breadwinners is Transforming Sex, Love, and Family. Liza, thanks so much for being here. So this shift, when did it start and what created it? It can't just be the recession for the numbers to be so big.
No, it started happening before the recession. The government's been tracking these numbers since the late 1980s, and the number of women who are outing their husbands has been rising steadily since then. You saw a real jump up in the In around 2000, you saw the numbers start to spike by about a percentage point every year. Part of it's the recession, but it's also because women are the majority of college students. They're taking the majority of associate's degrees, bachelor's degrees, PhDs, and master's degrees. They're half of students enrolled in law and medical schools, and the educational advantage is starting to show up in their paychecks.
And is that the reason why we see this other interesting finding from the Pew study, that total family income is higher when the mother and not the father is the breadwinner because of this, all these educational opportunities?
Right. I mean, wives now are more likely to be, if somebody in the marriage is more educated than the other, it's more likely to be the wife. In these dual earner households, it's also the case that when the woman is the primary earner in a marriage, it's more likely that both of them are working and she's out earning her husband's. If a man is the primary earner, then a certain number of wives would be stay at home. And so that's depressing the median earnings in those households where the man is the primary earner.
And we should make sure to not cloud over the fact this does not change the fact that there are still great income disparities,
right,
when it comes to men and women in the same jobs.
Correct. And so what you have is women who are primary earners in their households, but they're not making as much as a man might in the workplace. So you have women supporting households on less than a man might make. I mean, there used to be, and there still is to a certain extent, a premium for husbands and a premium for fathers. They call it, you know, the husband premium, the marriage premium for men. They would be, you know, earlier in the 20th century, that men would be paid more just because they were married, just because they were fathers and husbands. Women have traditionally been paid secondary supplementary wages, and the workplace still hasn't quite woken up to the fact that women are supporting their households. This isn't pin money, it isn't supplementary money, it's the primary money that's going to run these households and raise children.
Fascinating. Liza Mundy, thank you so much. Good luck with your book.